fun games with water. Everyone becomes happy when the rain arrives. Especially the children's happiness is boundless. Playing in the rain, floating paper boats, throwing stones in water have been part of our childhood. This video shows the characteristics of water with the help of water games played by the children. Come friends, along with Rama and Hari, let us learn that some things float on water and some things sink in water. The objectives of this video are A. To understand that some things float on water and some things sink in water. B. Classify the surrounding things on the basis of floating and sinking in water. C. Record observations in the form of a table.
Rama, look! How dense clouds are covering the sky! It looks like it's going to rain!
Yes, I love rain and I love to get drenched in the rain. Everything around us looks so beautiful. Our surroundings look clean, beautiful and washed up. Fields and plants get watered when it rains. Ponds also get filled up with rainwater. Water from rains keeps our earth so full and green.
Hey, it's raining! Let's play in the rain!
After some time, water is collected in the pits and puddles.
Today, it will be fun to play. Let's play!
Hari, you hit it so hard that the ghillie would sink in the pond.
Oh no, it will not sink. It's made of wood. I know things made of wood do not sink in water.
Oh, why wouldn't the wood sink?
Things that are very heavy sink in water, not the lighter ones.
Both move towards the pond, thinking about the phenomena of sinking and floating, when they see Chunnu.
Look, Chunnu is floating a paper boat in the water puddles. Wow, his boat is floating nicely.
Look, I told you light things float.
What is this, Hari? The boat started sinking. The paper is so light. Then how did the boat sink?
Rama, let's get our ghillie out from the pond. Then we will think about the boat.
Thankfully, our ghillie is floating and so many leaves are floating around.
Look, Rama, the flower is falling from the tree. Will they float or sink?
Do you think the flower will float or sink in the pond?
I suppose it will float because flowers are light.
There is a raw mango in my pocket. Let's put it in water. Will it float or sink? Maybe it will float because it is small and lighter than the ghillie.
Hey, the mango has sunk.
It means sinking and floating of an object is not dependent only on their weight or size. There may be some other reasons behind this.
Yes, otherwise the boat in which we cross the stream would sink as it is very heavy.
Let's find out why this happened.
Come friends, along with Rama and Hari, you also read the names of the things written in this list and guess which of these things will float and which will sink. Then you can experiment and see it for yourself.
Let's go home and see.
Take this big vessel. Put all the things one by one in this. Flowers, straws, pebbles, napkins. Hey, it floated for some time and then it sank.
Look at that. Papa has brought vegetables.
What are you doing?
We are testing which things will sink in water and which will float.
Wow! Let me also wash the vegetables.
We'll also help. Papa, why are the tomatoes floating and the potatoes sinking? Both have similar shapes.
Tell me, will the cauliflower float or sink?
A cauliflower is bigger than potatoes and tomatoes, so it will sink.
Hey, what is this? Cauliflower is floating too. Water is so strange.
Children, sinking or floating are not dependent on the size or shape of things.
Rama, tell me, will these onions, ladyfinger, ginger float or sink?
Why not do it for ourselves and see?
Friends, you too can perform this experiment with the vegetables found around you and share your observations with your friends.
Where has Chunnu gone?
Chunnu was playing in the rain. He must be bathing.
Let's go and find out.
Look at Chunnu. He is not taking a bath. He is playing.
Look, the soap is slipping from my hand and it is sinking in water.
But the soap case is floating.
Why don't we put the soap on the soap case?
Hey, this is a strange game. Now they are floating.
What do you think? Why did this happen?
When I push the mug upside down in the bucket, the mug instantly floats. When we keep it straight, it floats. And if it is a bit tilted, it gets filled with water and it sinks.
It is difficult to understand why water behaves strangely. Some things sink, some float in it. Sometimes the light thing sinks and heavy things float. Some things come upside down and some go straight to the bottom.
This is a strange but interesting story of water. Trying and doing a little bit every day, we have to solve this puzzle named water. Let's get it sorted out. What sinks and what floats? Let's find this out together.
We dirtied the whole water. It has to be thrown away.
Why are we throwing the water? It can be used to wash the floor, used in the bathroom or for the plants.
The proper use of water is very important. About 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered with neem. So you have to be careful. Otherwise, a day will come when I will disappear completely. If the children from each village, city, country and the world take responsibility, then my shortage can be reduced to a great extent.
Yes, from today I also take responsibility for becoming water watcher, and wherever I will see wastage of water, I will raise my voice and take action.
Don't you want to become water watcher too?
So friends, hope you have enjoyed watching the experiments with water.
You must try performing water-related experiments and know its characteristics. It's great fun to play with water and know more about it. Continue experimenting with water, but keep in mind that water should not be misused.
See you soon with our next video. Till then, happy water play!